If you're purchasing gifts for friends, family or work colleagues this holiday season, well, what better gift to give them than a wallet top-up, courtesy of Boost Gaming. Grab yourself a wallet top-up for PlayStation, Xbox, Nintendo or Blizzard, as well as supporting this channel this Christmas season by purchasing your wallet top-ups, courtesy of Boost Gaming. Link in the description below. Welcome back, football fans. Knockout stage football is upon us. Harry Kane surpasses Cristiano Ronaldo as the tournament's top goal scorer. All five of our Golden Boot candidates will participate in the last 16. And speaking of which, here is the revised knockout stage bracket, which should help paint a clearer picture of which country should face whom in the quarterfinals of Euro 2016. It's time for good old-fashioned tournament football. Let's hope for some drama and excitement coming our way here in France, Euro 2016 knockout stages. We make our first stop in the knockout stages in Saint-Étienne. The only fixture to imitate life is Switzerland versus Poland. Poland actually progressed on penalties after being deadlocked 1-1 against Switzerland after 120 minutes in the real knockout stage fixture in this same city. And we are on the way, the knockout stages kick off. Switzerland and Poland do have enticing form. The Swiss only losing to the powerful hosts of France, whereas Poland are actually undefeated, only conceding one goal, thanks to the champions of the world, Germany. However, Switzerland have scored more goals than their opponents today, with 7 goals in total in Euro 2016. Liechtenstein just gave it away, and now Lewandowski has a chance to punish them. Oh, and that's taken! Literally less than a minute. Robert Lewandowski is giving the Helvetians hell. To quote Joy Division, Stefan Liechtensteiner has lost control. Stefan Liechtensteiner literally gives it away to Milic, who gives way to the captain, Robert Lewandowski, who slaloms between Swiss defenders to give Poland the lead. And the first corner of the game will be taken by Poland, who wastes no time with a cross and has been tapped in off the forehead of Krzysztofek. Perfect start for Poland. 2 goals to the good, 10 minutes into the last 16 round against Switzerland, who are considered the other tournament's dark horses on this side of the bracket. It's all gone so wrong. Now, is Lewandowski too far out to shoot? Well, evidently not. It's not bad, but it's not good either. It was Xhaka, with Lyon to Memedi. That's a good cross in. It's nodded out for a corner by Glitch. Swung in. Bouhami knocks it down and is teabagged by Arthur. But actually, my mistake is a handball. Driven into Xhaka, who takes a shot. That's Switzerland's best chance yet. Xhaka is Jamali. Seferovic creeps into the area. Seferovic straight into the midsection of Szczesny. Lewandowski turns and opens up his body, pulls it wide just before half time. What a chance to end Switzerland's lives once and for all. Lewandowski's played perfectly on by Jury, and he's been pulled back by Fabian Schär, and hardly an expert in subtlety. At this point, you may as well rugby tackle him instead. Into the feet of Dirdiok. Fry turns and shoots, it's been rolled up by Chesney with ease. And Dirdiok knocks it over the bar. No chance of replicating, extra time now. Here's Krishnovec. Bent in for Lewandowski, he fires it straight at Sumner. Easier save he'll have to make all game. And Poland are comfortably through. Where they will either face Croatia, will be reunited with Germany. It is Switzerland 0, Poland 2. The winners of Group B, Wales, who surpassed England, have a handicap advantage to the quarterfinals in their first ever European Championships as they face Romania, who after a rollercoaster of a first round with the likes of France and Switzerland get a second chance at restarting their tournament. Thanks to a merciless performance against Albania, Romania are the first third place team to qualify for the Euro 2016 knockout stage. And Ledley wins that aerial duel against Stanciu. Now Stanciu to Stanciu, lays it off. Pintilli opens fire and skies it. Allen with the give and go, takes a touch and helps it through to Wendy King to take the crown, but he hits the post. Oh, and Gareth Bale is shut down at the near post with a heroic interception from Radzan Rutt. Romania dancing on thin ice twice in one blink of an eye. This is how close it is. Bale to take the corner, it's Ashley Williams. It's wide. Stanku. Adone. Pintilli back to Adone, who almost earned a hat-trick against Albania and almost scored the first for Romania here in Lons. Well, Pintilli buys a ticket and it whistles through the wind instead. Mihai Pintilli, he loves a strike from long range, doesn't he just? And that's a free pass down the line to Williams. Sends a searching ball into Bale and a far post! Tatu Asano with the save of a lifetime! Why in the world is this not a goal? Tatu Asano with the audacity of saving it with both hands! The power of Gareth Bale denied here in Lons. And now Bale slams on the brakes. Opens up his body for a cross in and it's denied once again by Cyprian Tatrashanu. This time off the kneecap of the goalkeeper. And now perhaps Wales beginning to feel the pressure of failing to score against the underdogs of Romania. Bale, oh, it's Gareth Bale that converted one free kick against Slovakia on match day one and able to repeat the magic trick against Tatrashanu's goal. Stanciu squeezes off a loose pass to Haban. Stanciu up the post just before half time. Imagine if Romania could shock the Dragons before the half time break. The game will be changed, undoubtedly. And now Gareth Bale, one more chance from the dead ball situation, and this time it's scooped up by Cyprian Tatrasani. Allen, King. It's Bale. He's waiting for support from Williams, but doesn't get it. Bale goes for it alone! And the deflection sets him up perfectly. Wales have taken the lead 3 minutes into the second half. And Romania seem to have so much to look forward to. After avoiding final destination situations in the first 45 minutes, it seemed the teammates may as well have collectively gone out and bought lottery tickets. But Gareth Bale proves there's no such thing as lady luck. 1-0 to Wales. Wales come forward again. It's going to be a cross. Bale is the only man in there. He tries to glance it on target. From Neil Taylor's decisive delivery. Bale was running away from the pass and he had to orient himself. A scrambled cross. Here finds Taylor. It's going to bring it down to Ledley, who converts for the second. Except the whistle is gone and it's not going to count. It is offside for Joe Ledley. It's about a yard off. Here's Claudio Cassero. Oh! A killer pass laid at the feet to Nicolas Stanciu. Romania's last roll of the dice rolls to zero. The Euro 2016 Odyssey of Wales continues into the quarterfinals. where they will challenge either Sweden or Portugal. It is Wales 1, Romania 0. The champions of the previous World Cup and the runners-up of the forthcoming tournament return to Paris. Germany had a very uncomfortable, very slow start to Euro 2016. It's not until the final 10 minutes against Northern Ireland their form started to warm up. Croatia will be feeling confident. They were their group winners ahead of the European champion Spain. Bedelj, Rakitic opens up for a teasing shot against Neuer. Modric. Now here's Ivan Perisic as he rolls the ball into the path of a strike. It just pebbles along the surface. Müller doesn't wait for Havertz to overlap him. And Ertel proves there's no need. The cross comes out of nowhere and it's a point blank volley under the chin of Daniel Subasic. The power behind it is almost excessive from point blank range. Ertel somehow onside and it's the first goal to Germany. Brilliant start. And Hummels goes clattering into Mandzukic like he was sliding on butter. Mario Mandzukic clutching his knee unfavorably. But it's not a free kick to Croatia. Where's Mandzukic? He plays on, not a big blow to the Croatians so far. Rakitic loses his footing and he's basically bashed off the ball. Modric. Bedelj. Here's Rakitic. There's a tempting amount of space to open fire on the captain. And the Croatians know Rakitic just needs that tiny opening. He loves the fire rockets. Ertel swings in the cross, but there's no one in the box. Whoa! Goethe found Draxler. They left it until the 11th hour to get into the penalty area. Kroos. And Goethe carries on his run. He slams the ball against the goalpost. A throw into Croatia. A last roll of the dice of the first half. Perisic has found Mandzukic. And he's offside anyway. Gudira. Lays it off to Kroos. Brilliant save from Subasic. This is probably the best Germany have looked all tournament. The clearance gets as far as Darius Serner. Bedelj, Rakitic, and it's Perisic who skies it. What a chance for Croatia. Leaning back and got carried away. It's Bedelj and Brozovic with some very erratic passing. Vršacek trying to restore a little bit of sensibility. He's seen it, a Croatian move. And it's nearly fired in by Rakitic again. Running out of fingers on one hand to count the amount of chances that Rakitic has had against the world champions. Verdes up the line to Andre Schürrle. With Müller continuing down the middle, it's still Thomas Müller to Gomez, who is unable to deliver the death blow to the Croatians. 5 more minutes for Croatia to find an equaliser. Manuel Neuer is in no man's land. Gomez. Oh, Luka Modric showing a little bit of fatigue as he lets it run through to Thomas Müller. And just like against Northern Ireland, it's another late goal that grants Germany some assurance and some relief. And they're going further in the tournament. And Luka Modric, Croatia's starlet, has to shoulder some of the blame for this. His ball watching allowed Thomas Müller to be well on his way. And Germany are through to the second round with their first clean sheet of Euro 2016. Whereas Joachim Löw managed to finally organise his world champions. It is Croatia 0, Germany 2. The hosts France would hate to lose to Turkey in Toulouse. France have won all three of their group games with a 100% record and only conceding one goal, and that was against Switzerland. Turkey narrowly through to the knockout stages for the first time since Euro 2008. Their late win over the Czech Republic saw them through as one of the best third place teams. The Crescent Stars are the underdogs as they take on not only one of the best teams in the tournament, but they have an entire country behind them. Hostile territory here in Toulouse for the usually intimidating Turks. Now Payet trying to hold the ball up for Matuidi. And Payet takes a bump. And he hasn't moved. Dimitri Payet may provide a big blow for France. He's unable to continue. And it'll be Anthony Martial, who's given a nod 1 minute into this second round fixture against Turkey. Pogba, Martial linking up in style. Oh, and he clips the post. Now, does the keeper get a hand on this? Does Babacan force this onto the goalpost? Comes off the left boot of Pogba. Yes, he does. It's a good save. Followed by a spring-loaded ricochet of the goalpost. Tosin. It's still Tosin. And that's tipped over by Lloris. And now Turkey throw their hat into the mixer. That's drilled in towards the far post. It's met by the head of Sahin. Turkey have a shot lead over France. And it's all thanks to a thumping header from Nuri Sahin. The corner kick was travelling outwards. And it's drilled home by the Dortmund playmaker. Hugo Lloris rooted to the spot. A tackle from Pogba. It's Giroud. Gives it back to Pogba. Tries to pass it in the top corner. It's Gökhan. Sahin. Tosin. Has overpowered Adel Rami. Oh my god, it's inches wide. Turkey comes so close, literally an inch away. Griezmann. Sanya. Cross aiming for Martial at the far post. Who fails to volley it. Evra reads the run of Pogba. Pogba has to go for it by himself. It's another good save from Babacan. Although Paul Pogba would have been offside anyway. Sahin. Now Tufan. Tufan! It's slapped away by Lloris! And a poor save, and it's been tipped on the bar. Defying gravity, defying logic from this follow-up. What a chance. How did Lloris keep this out? Just enough power on this for it to not only ricochet like a can of worms, but it just rolls in slow motion and just clips the crossbar whilst everybody in the blue shirt watches on in horror. There's Olivier Giroud on the overlap, and France started the second half strongly, but he pings it across the face of goal. Crossing opportunity for Pogba. Conte passes it into the heels of Topal, and Giroud just lunges. Again, more agony for the hosts, who are desperate to equalise. And they're just within touching distance of converting this ball into the back of the net. Tweedy changes his mind, goes for a cross for Giroud! Strong save by Babacan! Oh, it seems like the stars are lining up for the Crescent Stars here at Euro 2016. They're frustrating France. Here's Griezmann. Now Griezmann still going, stays on his feet, resists the urge to take a tumble, and it almost pays off. There's a rare attack from Turkey, and it's fell down to Sahin, and he tries to knock it on in the end. Although it was in vain. Griezmann swings it in for Sissoko! France have equalised 12 minutes before the end of the game. And once again, Momo Sissoko, he scores with his first touch. He's just come off the bench. And Babacan, who's been brilliant all game, he gets this wrong. He comes out for no reason. Sissoko trying to make his influence felt once again. Giroud misses, and Matuidi can't follow up. Too many players in the way. Özcan lays it off to Inan. He fires ahead of Topal, but he's offside. Very cagey affair now. We're into the final 3 minutes of the game. There's a long ball forward, and in it's locked over the head of Lloris. Any further off his goal line, and it would have been the end for France. But nonetheless, there's no end in sight yet. We have extra time. 30 more minutes of football for the first time at Euro 2016. Sissoko. Koscielny looking for Griezmann at the far post. If for some reason doesn't jump. He doesn't jump for a sitter of a cross. Schneiderlin pokes it into the path of Giroud. Topal soaks it up like a sponge. And we are due for our first penalty shootout of the tournament. And the underdogs Turkey have a lifeline here. It's all about the luck of the draw. Olivier Giroud will do the honours to take the first penalty for the hosts. It's Giroud versus Babacan. Olivier Giroud scores, even though Babacan goes the correct way. Now Sancho Kenan to equalise for Turkey, straight down the centre. It is Paul Pogba of Juventus to put France in front, and he does. Babacan rooted to the spot of Burak Yılmaz to equalise for Turkey. He does. It's all even here in Toulouse. Antoine Griezmann take his penalty. It's saved by Babacan. Urcha Cup to put Turkey within touching distance of the quarter final. He's pulled it wide. Anthony Martial, the first minute substitute, to finally find the back of the net if he can score past Babacan. And he does. Çalhanoğlu to keep Turkey going. And he does. He chips it over Lloris with the Panenka. Momo Sissoko, France's hero. It's equalised for them. Can he score from the spot? He does. And now if Turkey misses and France score their next penalty, then France will go through to the quarterfinals. Mehmet Topal. And he finds the back of the net. The penalty shootout must continue. Miss Bakary Sagna. Sagna, it's saved. And that puts Turkey in pole position to steal it right from under the host's noses. And it will be Chana Ökün to be the hero for the Crimson Stars. Ökün, he hits the crossbar. All the pressure falls on the shoulders of Patrice Evra. He's normally cold as ice. And he confirms for us all that his blood is indeed blue. And now is the captain, Arda Turan. If he misses, it's all over. Turan to keep Turkey alive. He doesn't. Lloris ends it for Turkey after a fantastic game of drama. The hosts are still in their own competition. France go through to the quarterfinals, where they will meet either England or Austria. And their captain, Hugo Lloris, can take all the credit. Two saves from the penalty shootouts. It is France 1, Turkey 1, followed by a thrilling 5-4 on penalties. What an encounter. Will the Irish find their luck in Lille? Well, they took a lashing from the departing Italians, and now they have to hold their own against an in-form Ukrainian side who are undefeated but was held by Ireland's neighbours of the north. Can the Yellows join their neighbours Poland in the quarterfinals? However, whoever gets through, it won't get any easier. Either Belgium or the European champion Spain awaiting the quarterfinals. Yarmolenko connects with the corner. And it's thrown up in the air by Darren Randolph. And it's Yarmolenko again. And this time he hits the post. It's a double whammy for Ukraine's number 7. Yarmolenko, who has been one of Ukraine's most influential players in this tournament, sends a cross in, and Zhijula has gotten sandwiched between O'Shea and Clark. And something is stopping him from getting back to his feet. Maybe something in his back exploded as he jumped into the air. Nonetheless, he'll be replaced by Yevhen Selezniov. Here's Selezniov. He's won a handball. Yarmolenko to take the free kick, and that's sent in. And it's converted by Kakaridi to give the Ukraine the edge over Ireland in this knockout stage fixture. Not to say Ireland don't have tall defenders, but Kakaridi's towered over all of them. As Walters scored the only goal of the game against Italy, and if not for the deflection, could have scored another one against Ukraine. Yarmolenko cuts inside for the cross. It's met by Selezniov. Keen to justify his appointment ahead of the injured Roman Zhijula. Konoplyanka Stepanenko. It's Kovalenko. Yarmolenko. And now there we go. Yevhen Zeleznyov. Challenge completed as he comes off the bench and justifies the substitution with a goal. Ireland never truly appeared threatening. Ukraine were comfortable in possession before, and now they can begin to relax. Excellent header, prodded on by Stalin Randolph. Robbie Keane waiting for support as he lays it off to Robbie Brady. Well, the two Robbies combining, and Brady hits a thunder strike against the goalpost. What a first time hit. Would have been the perfect way into the game for the Irish. Gadeski up the line to Yarmolenko. It doesn't stop providing for the Ukraine. Would have been game, set and match if it wasn't for Randolph. It's Kovalenko. Now Zeleznyov cuts inside O'Shea. Oh, and he's fired it wide. Ukraine are looking for more. Kovalenko returns the 1-2 pass to Zeleznyov, who carries on going, and it's Zeleznyov who gets his brace. And now with the potential departure of their starting striker, Roman Zajula, who may well miss the rest of the tournament. Well, Yevhen Zeleznyov is keen to assure the Ukraine that their strike force is in good hands. It's Keane, wastes no time with the cross in. He's dropped along. Things have just gotten progressively worse for Ireland since they beat Belgium on match day 2. It's a chance for a consolation from the corner. And they will get one. It is McCarthy who threads it through. Well, the Irish are going to need more than luck to turn this game around with 4 minutes left on the clock. Konoplyanka fails to clear it. And McCarthy reaps the benefits. Excellent header though. Well, the Ukraine continue to impress, but dark horses are still unbeaten. Yevhen Zeleznyov asks, who needs Zajula or Shevchenko? It's Ukraine 3, Ireland 1. It was a bittersweet group stage for Sweden. They were thrashed by Belgium, but they did beat Italy. As for Portugal, they only had one rocky bump in the road, and that was a draw against Austria. Vesely Shao are the favourites to return to this venue for the final, just as he did on that day 4 years ago. Two of Europe's best strikers, who need no introduction, come head to head on opposite sides of the pitch. Well, in an ideal world, we could have played football together for the same club. Two of the most unpredictable and charismatic strikers. And Cristiano Ronaldo and Zlatan Ibrahimovic is Portugal versus Sweden here at the Stade de France. Martinez slams on the brakes, switching the cross for Danilo. It was an excellent header and it would have counted for nothing. Here's Lewicki. He's wrapped a splendid pass through to Marcus Berg. And Sweden have stunned Portugal by taking the lead through their top goal scorer, Marcus Berg. And it is his fourth goal now for the Scandinavians in this tournament. Excellent movement, shocking Pepe and his shocking haircut. Portugal's defence totally lopsided. Well, that is a brilliant ball from Oscar Lewicki. And the credit goes to Marcus Berg for a fantastic first time finish. Lewicki, and he may have done it again. There's a through pass springing the Portuguese trap. Ibrahimovic is kept out by Patricio. Kim Charleston passes the parcel to Zlatan Ibrahimovic, fires through the legs of Ariana. And it's just barely denied by Patricia. Andre Gomez, Nani. Back to Gomez. And the shot was rising and rising. He's a man who scored Portugal's first goal of Euro 2016. João Mário. Ariana. Ronaldo. Danilo with another chance to redeem himself, and this time he hits the crossbar. Portugal continue. 30 minutes played, Portugal are losing. It's Nani to take a corner. Martinho, Ronaldo tries to square it, it finds Pepe. Danilo again with a third, guilty chance. Another chance for Portugal from the set piece. This time Pepe can't change the direction of the game. Martinho fending off the yellow shirts. Ronaldo in there by himself. Jamaria back to Ronaldo. Why did Ronaldo pass? Shooting opportunity and an uncharacteristic lack of judgment from CR7. Here's Ibrahimovic. And he set it up for Berg again. And Marcus Berg hits the post this time. Well, Sweden could have been 3 goals up by now. The dark horses are lighting up Portugal's end of the pitch. And Sweden put a bigger smile on Erik Hamrén's face at half-time. Larsson, shot blocked by Jean Mario, finds his way to Ibrahimovic. He's skidding his way in, off in the palms of Patricio. It wouldn't be a European Championship without a trademark Zlatan Ibrahimovic scissor kick. Wow, Portugal failed to clear their lines and don't they just know it. As he comes off the backside of Pepe. And finally off the elbow of Patricio. It just ricocheted around the area like a pinball. Second goal for Zlatan. None for Ronaldo so far, but Portugal are losing half-time to the underdogs. Guerrero on the follow-up. And Martinho, he tries to glance it on. He scored that way against Iceland on match day one. Martinho. It's an odd one over the top, but it does reach Jean Mario. And Ronaldo is banged out by Granqvist. And Sweden ain't stopping for nobody. Until the referee orders them to. Ronaldo stayed down, and this doesn't look good at all. In the same stadium where he was carted off in the final and missed the rest of it. It looks like Andreas Granqvist will repeat history for Cristiano Ronaldo. And he will be replaced by Eder. Now he scored in the final against France. They're going to need him to repeat that trick more than ever now. Andre Gomes gets something on it. It's just not accurate enough. Danilo. Andre Gomes. Eder is going to collect it instead. And he hits the post. That's the second time for Portugal. They struck the woodwork. Danilo. There's Martinho in the centre. Straight at Isaksen. Nani out wide, just to orient himself and get across it. Danilo, once again, hitting the woodwork, he's cursed. Danilo is cursed. It was either now or never for Portugal to get their way back in the game. And if he can't score from these opportunities, it's not going to happen. Off the crossbar, off the post, Isaksen saves it with his face and Danilo denied a tapping. Nani, Ada's there, he can't keep it down. Euro 2016 continues to surprise. Sweden, the underdogs have knocked out Portugal. For it will be them who will face Gareth Bale and Wales in Lille. It's Portugal 0, Sweden 2. It is now time for arguably the most mouth-watering encounter of the second round. It is Belgium versus Spain for the right to face the Ukraine in the quarterfinals. There is a sea of red that adorns Parc Olympique Lyonnais. The Red Devils, Belgium, have fired a warning at their Spanish opponents via a thrashing of Sweden, 5-2 in their final group stage encounter. However, the reigning defending European champion Spain are finding their feet. Alvaro Morata is their top goal scorer with 3 goals to his name. Lolito gets support from Thiago. And it's back to Nolito, cuts inside, but that cross is dropped to David Silva. Spain wasting no time at all, attempting to extinguish the fire of the Red Devils. Silva hoping to invest in Spain, reaching their third European Championship final in a row. Silva with a cross, it's been glanced on by Morata. And that might have tricked Courtois because he couldn't hold it. Now England. Lukaku, nice turn and pass to Fellaini. Here's De Bruyne. De Bruyne opens up his body and shoots anyway. It's going to be a corner kick. I don't think he's confident about reaching Lukaku in that situation. Here's Seaman. That's a very good ball in. Lukaku gets underneath the cross. Into the upwards trajectory. Here's Lukaku. Witzel is trying to overlap. Lukaku has to change gears. I haven't seen much of Emily Lukaku until the previous game against Sweden, of which he scores two goals against the Scandinavians. Thiago, it's a good idea for a pass. Morata just needs to make a payoff, and he's taken it way too early. He was rushed by Thomas Vermaelen. Will he find goal number four? Seaman, De Bruyne, Lukaku, he has Fellaini joining it. It was way too good to be true. Lukaku once again surrounded by white shirts. May take any chances with him. But it allows them to let Witzel slip through. Milito finds Thiago Alcantara. And the former Barcelona playmaker nearly granted Spain the perfect start to the second half. Thiago, Fabregas, that's the perfect first touch to set up Morata. How did he squander that? It's hardly as if he's been goal shy in this competition. We've got to go if that's the best chance Spain have had so far. Lukaku's brought down. Free kick territory for Kevin De Bruyne. Here's De Bruyne, and De Gea didn't like it one bit. Swatted out the sky like a disgusting spider with 99 eyes. It was directly at him, but something spooked him about this ball. Mertens just waiting for De Bruyne to catch up with him. He ignores Witzel, goes back to Mertens, he finds Lukaku! Oh my God, what a goal! What the hell just happened? How did this happen? It's like Mertens didn't even look to see where Lukaku was, just got it in the mix-up and hoped. And this ball is going way past Lukaku. It's heading out of the solar system and Lukaku volleys it back into orbit. Crash landing in David De Gea's planet known as the goal. Now Mertens gets intercepted. Hazard will keep up the pressure. Lukaku takes it perfectly. Two spectacular goals from Romelu Lukaku. It's a Belgian bonanza of brilliant goals. Sergio Ramos fails to connect with the interception. Lukaku doesn't fail though, he doesn't miss. Exceeding expectations. That is a wonder volley. European champions dealt two heavy blows by Belgium and they got 10 minutes to find a way back into this. Otherwise the European Championship defence is all over. And now they have a free kick. Fabregas is off the crossbar and in. Cesc Fabregas has pulled the goal back. We've just under 8 minutes to go. Well, the game was a stalemate for a long time. And now we have three entertaining goals to show for it. Good quality free kick from Cesc Fabregas. Gets a nice little aesthetic helping hand. Clipping the underside of the woodwork. Across his line and bounces into the roof of the net. It's game on here in Lyon. Nyan Glenn has found his way round. Lukaku is 1-on-1. Oh, he takes no prisoners. It's a hat-trick for Romelu Lukaku. David De Gea has no chance in the universe. Look at the power. Lukaku is waking up. A late bloomer to the tournament is a hat-trick for Romelu Lukaku. And Belgium confirmed that we will have new European champions. The title defence of Spain is all over. The torch shall be passed. Lukaku claims the match ball. It is Belgium 3, Spain 1. Of course, it wouldn't be knockout stage football without England now, would it? We all know what happened at the real stage of this competition. The smallest team in the tournament, Iceland, sent England home with a whimper. However, their opponents tonight, Austria, are far from pushovers. They are unbeaten. England, however, are not. England had a nightmare of a first half against Slovakia in the previous game until they applied cruise control. Is football coming home or is it going home? It's that time of the tournament. England versus Austria. Uncharacteristic mistake from David Alaba might have set England up. Dele Alli may have gotten too excited. The shot was rising on the weak foot. Dyer. It's Harry Kane. Wayne Rooney. Dele Alli is overlapping, but Rooney ignores it. It's back to Eric Dyer. And that's a good spot to Harry Kane. Tottenham teammates combining. There's Christian Fuchs. Swings an early one in to Janko. And Joe Hart haphazardly punches it away. Ali has another good ball to Rooney. And he strikes the post. Here's the first decent opportunity that England have had so far. Rooney spotted an opening and took it. Von Gartlinger. Janko. Now Junuzovic. Catches a deflection on the way through. Corner kick. Probably should have been more. May have been a handball from Kyle Walker. And Sabitzer at the near post. Unlucky. Alaba. Nodded back in by Junuzovic. Walker with a crossing opportunity. Hits the body of Christian Fuchs. Lallana. Squares it into the centre to Danny Rose, of all people. He's in the middle shooting range. Lallana with the delivery for England. Ali takes it on the chest. Straight as an arrow at Almet. As England trying to find a breakthrough just before half-time. Well, Gartlinger's lost it. Lallana, here's England's chance. Rooney takes it early. England have been in control. Should be a good omen for the second half. Sterling. And Almer comes out into no man's land. If only Chris Smalling could keep it down. Von Gartlinger. Alaba. It's a good move from Austria. Here's Junuzovic. Austria have a chance to muddy the waters for England before half time. Fuchs. Finds Harnage. Who scores? And England trail once again just before half time. They're making a habit of this. Martin Harnage. Scores his second goal in two games and gives Austria the lead for the second game in a row. Now Hodgson has to revise a new strategy for England at half-time. Down the line to Klein. Cuts inside Cahill. Janko meets it. Dele Alli to Sterling, who tries to drill it into the path of Kane and is caught out by Almet. Dele Alli, plenty of space. Goes for the cross in though. Sterling stands no chance against Christian Fuchs, who gives away the penalty. The Austrian captain may have gave England a lifeline. And it's a very surprising substitution from Hodgson. Harry Kane has been replaced by Daniel Sturridge. England's top goalscorer has been taken off when they're losing. Rooney converts the penalty. And it's game on here in Nice. It's taken England an hour to find their first goal against Austria. And we warned you, it wouldn't be easy. Wayne Rooney has no time for placement, opting instead for the unadulterated power. Klein directly into the feet of Janko. Is Baumgartlinger! Wonderful passage of play from the Austrians. That would have been a sensational goal. And it was swerving away from Joe Hart. Sterling racing David Alaba. He slams on the brakes and deceives him. Punched away from the head of Sturridge. It's Lallana. Wiped out by Baumgartlinger. That was a violent tackle. And it's a mystery how he escapes with a yellow card. Look at this, so high on the shins. He launched Adam Lallana to the moon. There's a chance for Wayne Rooney to be England's hero. To convert the free kick. And it wasn't good. England has 10 shots to Austria's 5. And Daniel Sturridge makes it a 6th. Time is wearing thin. England are trying to avoid extra time. Milner tries to land it in the lap of Chris Smalling, who goes down. But it's not going to be a penalty, it was just barely on the outside of the area. Smalling needs to maintain some decorum. He needs to remember what's at stake and where he is. There's another chance for Rooney. He doesn't, he lays it off. Milner to Sturridge! Well, that was unorthodox. England's last chance to win it is squandered as they now face extra time in the knockout stage of tournament football for England. Rooney has found Milner, who has to take it early. Reliable save by Almer, he wasn't taking any chances. Luckily for him, James Milner was offside. It's a wayward pass from Martin Harnage, Austria's goal scorer. Milner. Carries it on to Ross Barkley in the centre. He has Sturridge to his left. Barkley goes for it by himself. And the substitute that just gave England the lead. England turn it around. 13 minutes into extra time. Austria give this away. It's a horrible job. Von Gatlinger's trying to keep up with the fresh legs of Ross Barkley. He had Daniel Sturridge to the side of him for support. And he didn't need it in the end. Everton's Ross Barkley, England's unlikely hero. Here's Barkley again. It's a different game since he's come on. And now Sterling has a chance to put the game to rest. But he bottles a one-on-one chance. Rooney, Sterling, Sturridge is by himself, surrounded by red shirts. Has to work a little bit of magic. And he forces a save out of Almer. Incredible. Nice to see England out trying to hold on. They're trying to put a game beyond reach and win it once and for all. Klein down the line to Dragovic. Dragovic swings across in for Jankon. Oh my God! It's Joe Hart with the save of a lifetime. You don't need me to tell you about the paper hands of the real Euro 2016. The softest goals he would let in. But this time the gloves are made of granite. Alaba is punched out awkwardly by Hart. Alaba keeps it alive. Klein. Fuchs. Yunusovic chips it in and is pushed away by Harnic, who almost gets a second. Austria coming forward with a vengeance. Alessandro Schopp's cross is suppressed. And scoops up by Joe Hart. That was a risky throw out to Barkley. It's a long ball from Christian Fuchs. One final roll of the dice from Austria is squandered as Dragovic goes for grotesque glory. The crowd is whistling for the game to stop. It's David Alaba. Referee ends it. England survive. And they are into the quarterfinals, where they will meet their biggest challenge yet, the hosts, France. And they can thank Ross Barkley for calling off a penalty shootout. It is England 2, Austria 1. The Euro 2016 round of 16 comes to a close. A couple of shocks, plenty of thrilling games, and even a penalty shootout. And we're just getting started. The quarterfinals are upon us. Romelu Lukaku adds to his two goals they scored against Sweden with a hat-trick against the European champion Spain. That puts him at the top of the golden boot table. Marcus Berg levels proceedings with Harry Kane. Cristiano Ronaldo will contribute no more as Gareth Bale single-handedly drags Wales further and further into the tournament. And now here is your Euro 2016 quarterfinals. Poland and Germany meet once again. They drew 1-1 in the group stage. What will they have learned from each other this time? Two of the tournament's dark horses go head-to-head. One of them must go as Wales take on Sweden, who stunned Portugal. Will Ukraine bring the pain to the team that eliminated Spain? Belgium are also heavy favourites. And finally, it's the English Channel Derby that hosts France versus the Three Lions England. That'll take place at the Stade de France, arguably the biggest of the four quarterfinals. Once again, thank you all for watching. If you fancy making a contribution to the channel via the Patreon for as little as £1, you can join Matt Lacabone in doing so. You can even join me on my personal Discord, where you can tell me about your life, your love for PES, shoot the breeze and join the community. The link is in the description below. Well, I hope you found the first round of knockout football enjoyable. Did your country make it through to the final eight? And which one of those quarterfinals are you looking forward to the most? Let me know in the comments below. If you haven't already, don't forget to like, subscribe and follow me on Twitter. And as always, thank you for watching.